So solutions are not so complicated. And most of all for hate, I wondered what we could do. And if you could show the second film, my friends at the back. I decided that you can only, if you have to fight darkness with darkness, only it'll get more dark. You can't fight hate with hate. You have your hate and I'll have my hate. How do we develop a fighting back with love? And so I made a call for something that we call the Karwane Mohabbat, a caravan of love. And we said we will visit every single family where somebody has been lynched in their homes. And we'll do four things. Firstly, we'll say, we want you to know that you're not alone in your suffering. Second is, we want to seek your forgiveness for what you're suffering, because all of us together as a country, you and I, are responsible that we've allowed our country to become what it has become. And thirdly, in your fight for justice, we will stand with you. And fourthly, we will tell your story. And it is important to tell your story, because in Germany, as I say in this small film clip, in Germany, later generations would keep asking, how did you remain silent after the 1930s? And the big defense that people gave was, but we did not know. And I am resolved that I am not going to let you say I did not know, because we will tell you. And we will keep telling you till your conscience aches unbearably. So if I could have the second film, please, then.
मुझे लगता है कि कायर तो वो है जो हाथ उठाता है कमजोर पर लोगों के दिलों में डर पैदा करता है असली साहस तो वो है जो इस सब के बीच में नफरत का सामना करता है
एक चोट है जो हमारे अपने ह्यूमैनिटी पर लग रही है हमारे अपने जमीर पर लग रही है हमारी अपनी इंसानियत पर लग रही है
सारे हिंदुस्तानियों की एक किस्म की सेंसिटिविटी भी नम हो गई है अब हमारे लिए एक लिंचिंग का जो खबर आती है कहीं चौथे पांचवें पेज पे उसको हम इसी तरह से पढ़ जाते हैं
इन यात्राओं में अब हम लोग 1.5 साल से जा रहे हैं लोगों के घर जो चेहरे नहीं भूलते ज़्यादातर वो उन बूढ़े माँ बाप के हैं जिन्होंने जवान बेटे खोए हैं वो ये कंप्लेन नहीं करते कि मेरे बेटे को क्यों मारा वो इस स्टेज पर आ चुके हैं कि वो कहते हैं अरे गोली मार देते तलवार से मार देते इतना टॉर्चर करके क्यों मारा
किसी को भीड़ द्वारा ये पीटा नहीं जा रहा है क्योंकि उन्होंने कुछ किया इसलिए उनको भीड़ द्वारा पीटा जा रहा है क्योंकि वो कुछ हैं
हमने देखा है कि लोग किस तरह से उन्हें सिर्फ मारा ही नहीं गया डराया गया है तो एक खौफ का पूरा जो माहौल है एक खौफ का दौर जो पूरा पैदा कर दिया गया है वो भी इस नफरत के साथ साथ पूरा हुआ है
थ्रेटनिंग वॉइस में कहा जाता है और मारते हुए कहा जाता है कि भारत माता की जय बोलो वंदे मातरम बोलो प्रूफ करो कि तुम पाकिस्तानी नहीं हो या पाकिस्तान को सपोर्ट नहीं करते हो तुम सबूत दो कि तुम इस देश को चाहते हो
उन्हें नहीं कहने की जरूरत पड़नी चाहिए हमारे आगे पर वो कहते हैं हम बाय चांस नहीं हम बाय चॉइस इस कंट्री में रुके थे हम इस मुल्क को बहुत प्यार करते हैं हम तो ये भी करते हैं हम वो भी करते हैं पैर पैर पर उन्हें अपनी राष्ट्रवादी होने का सबूत उनसे मांगा जा रहा है
शायद वक्त ये आ गया है कि इस देश की जो मेजॉरिटी कम्युनिटी है हम लोग जिनको ये कॉन्फिडेंस है कि हम विक्टिमाइज नहीं होने वाले हैं मुझे कोई मेरे घर से खींच के नहीं निकालेगा और कहेगा कि भारत माता की जय कहो तो हम लोग किस देश में रहते हैं किस देश में रहना चाहते हैं हमने किस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को इनहेरिट किया है उसकी तरफ हमारी क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि हम लोग जानते हुए कैसे अनजान बन सकते हैं, ये अब हमारे लिए मुमकिन नहीं होना चाहिए।
तो इतना तो हमने तय किया कि हम अपने देशवासियों को ये बचाओ उनके खामोशी को के लिए देने के लिए तैयार नहीं। हमने तो बताया और हम बताते रहे और हम बताते रहेंगे। हम लिखेंगे, हम बोलेंगे, हम फिल्म बनाएंगे, हम हर तरह से बोलते रहेंगे जब तक आपका जमीन तक हम पहुंच नहीं पाए, तब तक हमारा काम बोलने का खत्म नहीं होगा। तो ना सिर्फ हम आपके दुख में शामिल हैं बल्कि हम माफी भी मांगना चाहते हैं कि हमारा देश इस हालत में पहुंचा है, जिस हालत में नफरत इतनी फैल गई कि आपके परिवार जनों को इस तरह से मारा जाना पड़ा।
सो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ माय कॉन्वर्सेशन विद यू, आई वांट टू सॉर्ट ऑफ अंडरलाइन फर्दर why I believe that compassion, call it fraternity, call it bandhuta, but also call it radical love, is a solution to all of those three problems that I laid before you of inequality with indifference, of rising hate and legitimized bigotry that we see around us, and what I did not have time to speak about, which is climate change. For all of these, we need to nurture in our societies, in our own hearts, and we have to fight with love. Talk about inequality. Many of us are talking about universal social rights. You know, can we think about fighting for a country now where, with the wealth and resources that we have, we ensure universal education, universal healthcare for all, universal pensions for the aged. Social protection. Noam Chomsky, one of the world's greatest, one of the world's greatest public intellectuals, said, what is social protection? He said, social protection is ultimately the idea that we should take care of each other. The idea that we should take care of each other. I think it's a profoundly beautiful idea. I remember when I in the National Advisory Council, when I was, we drafted the Food Security Act, and we were advocating for it. I remember the week when it was being debated in Parliament. I was in one television discussion after the other, and everybody was angry, including the anchors, every anchor, not just the anchor who's normally angry. All of them were angry. So I couldn't understand where this rage is coming from, when all we are saying is there's food and let's ensure that every person gets at least enough food to survive. And one industrialist, quite well known, very well known, normally quite sober, she in one of the debates, she turned to me and she said, what's wrong? I've made my money. I worked hard. I made my money. I have done nothing to harm the economy. Why should I be taxed to feed the poor? And suddenly I understood where this rage was coming from. And I said, the poor work much harder than you. They've done much less to harm the economy. But why should I be taxed to feed the poor? Because we must take care of each other. It's as simple as that. The idea of radical love is also love that is based on enormous courage. Now think back, I mean, look at what has happened around Kashmir, look at what is happening each of these days. We're having no political leader who has the courage to speak out. Think back of 1947, 46, 47. A million people had died in Hindu-Muslim riots, 1 million people. Another country had been constituted on the basis of religion. Rivers of blood were flowing. Train loads of people were coming in both directions with everybody slaughtered. My own family is from Rawalpindi. I've grown up with all the stories of the horrors of those times. In that, for Mahatma Gandhi to be able to stand up and say, no, even so, this country will belong equally to all. This country belongs equally to its Muslims, to its Christians, to its Hindus, to people of every faith. It required enormous courage. It was for that that his life was taken. His last battle in Delhi, a few months before he died, he was very depressed. So Anis Kidwai writes, her husband was killed in the riots, and she came to Mahatma Gandhi and spoke to him. And he said, Beti Mera, my work will not be done until, and see how he put it, he said, until a Muslim child cannot walk without fear in this city and in this country, my work will not be done. And think of what country we have created and how far we have gone from the India that he dreamed of. We might think, this is something that, that big people can do. What about us? Just in our everyday lives, how can we demonstrate and fight back with love? Mother Teresa said something quite beautiful. She said, not all of us are capable of great things, but every one of us is capable of doing small things with great love. And the last video that I wanted to show you was a very ordinary, just please see it. The video is...
Sikanji to Sikanji hai, sir, uska wahi dharam nahi hai. अच्छा लगता है आपस में मिल के बैठ के बनवाते हैं लोगों के लिए तो अच्छा लगता है हमें सिकंजी बनाता हूँ ऐसा अच्छा लगता है लोग आते हैं ये तो रमजान का महीना तो चैरिटी और बेनेवोलेंस के लिए ही माना जाता है ने दे रखा है लोग सिकंजी पीते हैं तो मेरे को कहते हैं भाई अच्छा बनाया तुमने मतलब सुबह से भूखा प्यासा है उसका गला गीला हो जाता है उसके बाद तो मैं सबको सिकंजी पिलाता हूँ
हमारे शॉप के अगल बगल सारे लोग काफ़ी रमज़ान का इंतज़ार करते हैं और कहते हैं भाई आप लोग का रमज़ान कब होगा
हम तो भाई दस्तखान लगाते हैं अब उसमें रोज़े वाला भी आ जाए बगैर रोज़ेदार भी आ जाए मुसलमान भी आ जाए गैर मुस्लिम भी आ जाए कोई ऐसा रोक टोक नहीं है और आते हैं लोग आस पड़ोस से भी आते हैं हमारे सामने लाला जी हैं उनके भी हम इफ्तार भेजते हैं खाना जो फ्रूट चाट
शेयर सारी जगह होता है पूरी मार्केट में होता है हम तो कई सालों से इकट्ठे खा रहे हैं कई जगह से इफ्तार आती है और इफ्तार करवाते भी हैं साथ में मिल के खाते हैं पता ही नहीं चलता कि कौन क्या है और कौन कहाँ गया है अस्सलाम वालेकुम बोलते हैं मुसलमान राम राम बोलते हैं यहाँ कोई ऐसी दिक्कत नहीं है यहाँ हिंदुस्तान है पूरा
बचपन से ही कर रहे हैं कोई भी धर्म का हो मैं खुद हिंदू हूँ लेकिन मेरे को अच्छा लगता है मुमिन के साथ अफ्तारी करना मैं ईद पे भी जाता हूँ मेरे फ्रेंड लोग आते हैं हम लोग दिवाली ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि मुमिन हिंदू इस टाइप का हमारा सोच नहीं है कभी घर से भी नहीं है और कभी ऐसा कहीं सोचा भी नहीं
So this young boy, Chandan, in a sense, is doing exactly what Mother Teresa said. He's doing small things with great love. And all of us can do that. In my work with homeless people, I learned that you have to hire blankets in Delhi. It gets very cold, and they actually have to hire blankets for 30 rupees, 40 rupees. And it's very difficult for a homeless person to decide whether I should eat my meal or hire a blanket. But I noticed one night that people who were completely, the oldest and the weakest, all had blankets. So I wondered how that happened. And the homeless people told me, but we know that they would die in a single night if they didn't have blankets. So when we gather at night, we all pool money first to hire blankets for the old and the destitute among us. And then we see whether we can manage it for ourselves. You know, kindness is not that difficult to find. And I found the greatest kindness in those who have the least. Dr. Ushaji read out, Ida Scudder's favorite lines from the Bible about what love is. Every tradition teaches us that. Many of you would not be familiar with, say, the Muslim tradition. So I learned, for instance, that Prophet Muhammad said, when you see great suffering or injustice, what is your duty? He said, at the very least, respond from your heart, which means at least care. The better human being then responds from the tongue, which means that you speak out against the injustice. And the best human being responds with the hands, which means that you act against injustice and suffering. Most of you gathered here are responding with your hands. But at the very least, if we can ensure in the way we raise our children, that at least they begin to respond from the heart. Some of them might also respond from the tongue. Let them at least care. I think if India has to be saved, the very least and the very most that we need is to nurture kindness. Let us at least nurture kindness. Let us at most nurture kindness. And I'll end with one story of radical love, which moved me a lot. There was much that we saw during our karma. Asansol in Bengal has now become a place where hatred is being created and violence and fights. Ram Navami never used to be celebrated there, but that is being used to create. So a riot was created during one of the Ram Navamis. Classic situation happened that curfew was imposed. Two Hindu boys had got caught up in the Muslim area, and one Muslim boy, who was the son of this imam, 16-year-old son, got caught up in the Hindu area. And people said, we will return only if you return, and so on. The imam said, this is completely wrong. Think of what the parents of these two young children, the Hindu parents, would be feeling. And without any conditions, we will return these two children. And he hoped that his son would be returned. And he waited, waited. Midnight, he gets a call from one of the officers that, we're sorry, we found your son, but he's dead. He's been killed. His first response is, don't tell anybody. If this news gets out, the whole city will burn. Many innocent people will be killed. I will tell them. So the next morning, in the morning namaz, after the prayers, he says, I have this news to share with you. My son has been killed. And this is a great tragedy. But he says, a much greater tragedy to me would be if, even by your tongue, let alone by your hands, you harm a single Hindu in revenge. And I've gone there a few times. The young boys, young men there, were weeping then. They were weeping when they spoke to me. They said that after he said that, instead they all went out, and the Hindus who were in the Muslim area, they stood and protected them, their homes, their shops. Later that morning, they gave the body of the boy, and as I was saying, his eyes were gouged out. His body had been, he'd been tortured badly before he'd been burnt. I saw the pictures. But the imam was completely firm that there will be no anger and there will be no revenge. And so we don't have to wait for, you know, looking for the Mahatma, waiting for Mother Teresa. I think it is all around us. If we understand the meaning of compassion, if we understand the idea that we are bound to and with each other, if we learn that we owe a duty to care for each other, only then can we find an answer to the world's problems in this most cruel period in recent human history. And you and I have to decide what world we want to leave to our children. And to find our way, the only thing we really need is to nurture our capacities for kindness. Thank you.